Hi, this is Hadas from I Can Canva, and in this tutorial I'd like to show you how you can create your own frames using Canva. I call it DIY frames. You can create frames from any element or font that you wish. Let's go ahead and see how we do that. So I've opened up this new design sheet, and now I'm just going to go to elements and let's search for this example for cherry. Now let's pick any graphic of cherry, for example, this one. Do notice that once you click on that, you must have the option to change the color. But for example, this cherry, as you can see, has no option to change its color. So that will cause us some issues when we want to create a frame out of it. So make sure you pick one that is editable. You don't have to change the colors. You can, but you don't need to. And then just go to download and download as PDF standard. Now this process is absolutely free. You do not need a pro account for this one. So let's just click on download and save this in one of our files. So I'm just going to name this cherry one, and now let's open a Word document. So here I have a clean new document sheet. Let's go to file, click on open, and find our cherry. There it is. Once I click on that, let's enable editing. What I need to do is to click on my cherry and go up here to shape format. Once I click on that, I get the option of shape fill. Open that up, click on picture, and you can either pick a picture from a file you saved beforehand or pick an online picture. I went ahead and saved a background picture. This can be any background that you like. It doesn't matter what it looks like. So I'm just gonna double click on that and it filled my cherry. Let's go to file, click on save as, and let's save this as a PDF. Now let's open up Canva once more. Go to create a design, click on import PDF. Let's pick our cherry frame. Once it's done uploading, click on that, and there you have it. Now notice that your cherry is actually made of different shapes. You can see that every time I click on a shape, it's individual. So what I need to do in this case is click on each shape and then just hit the delete key. And then it's revealed. You can see this beautiful frame underneath, and there you have your cherry. But it means that you need to drag your photo to each part individually. Not so much fun. If I want it all to be gold, then I just need to do this. Okay, possible, but if you don't want to do that, make sure that the element that you choose is in one piece. So let me show you how you can easily work with a frame that has only one color and comes in one piece. So let's go to elements once again, and in this case I'm going to search for butterfly. You can search any word you'd like, but make sure you don't pick a butterfly that consists of many colors. I'm just going to search for one that has only one color. Let's click on graphics, and for example I'll pick this one. So you see it has only one color. It means that when I'll drag into this frame any photo or video, I will not have to do this piece by piece. So I'm just going to quickly fast forward this and repeat all the process all over again. Go to download, PDF standard, and let's go ahead. And there it is. All I have to do is click on the butterfly, hit the delete key, and there is my beautiful, beautiful frame. Let's this time go to videos and drag a video. How about that? Now I want to show you how you can create frames out of fonts, but there are some things you must consider. So for this example, I've typed in the letter O and I've picked this font called Ananias, you get it. And now what I have to do if I want to do this for free using Word I must click on effects and change this font to hollow. If I will not do that, this will not work correctly. This is not an element, this is a font, so it's a different type of format. So once you've done that, just click on download, PDF standard, download this, save it in one of your files, head back again to Word. Now notice that what happens, two problems. Let's enable editing. What Word did is that it added another layer of font. So first of all, I need to get rid of that. So just hit the delete button. But notice that our font is missing. It doesn't have the inner circle. In this case, this technique would not be the best one to use. So your option would be to use PowerPoint. But to do this using PowerPoint, you must have a Canva Pro account. If you do not have a Pro account, I'll be more than happy to give you 45 days for free, no strings attached. You'll find the link below or just scan this code. Let's head back to Canva. In this case, we will have to save this and download it as an SVG file, which is a vector file. In this case, you don't need to use the hollow effect. You can use this font as it is. And let's go to download and pick this time SVG. Notice that this is a Pro account feature. So once I've downloaded this, saved it in my file, let's head back to PowerPoint. So I've opened up a new file, click on insert, pictures, this device, and pick your SVG file. Now we have it in its full. What we have to do now is go ahead and click on convert to shape. Once we do that, we get two frames, an outer frame and a frame within our font. So let's get rid of the big one. Just click on that, hit the delete key. And once we click on our font, we just go to shape fill and choose our background picture. So I have one that I saved in advanced, and there it is. Now the process from here is very similar. Just go to file, save as, and just save this as a PDF file. Let's head back to our Canva account, home screen, create a design, click on import PDF, and there you have it. In its full, it's perfect. All you have to do is click on the frame, hit the delete key, and the frame is revealed. Now I can just drag in any photo I'd like, or even drag in a video, and there you have it. Now, what you need to keep in mind is that for this to work, you need to have a Word version from 2013 and up. Hope you liked it.